Hi guys, sorry to keep you. Now it's actually time, now it's actually 14:02, and the, the execs from Rio Tinto are all leaving, and BMWs and Mercedes-Benzes, waiting for the guys to actually come out. I think it's actually they needed to, they're still probably inside at the moment. It is interesting that, these are the guys actually who profiteered off the backs of miners and also indigenous people in places like West Papua. I think this Madagascar as well. There's a few things that you can actually do. If you could industrial ugly truth about Rio Tinto. If you could actually check them out, that's www.industrial-union.org, and it will tell you all about Rio Tinto. I have to point out though that they didn't actually mention anything about the TTIP. Anyone who knows about the TTIP, one of the most pernicious, invidious parts of the TTIP is called the ISDS, Investor State Dispute Settlement. At this moment in time, Infinity Gold is suing Costa Rica for $1 billion. $1 billion, all to do with due to environmental laws in Costa Rica. They were prevented from opening a gold mine. The local people didn't want it either, so that means, hey, they're going to end up with their cyanide in their rivers and on their water supply and on the soil. Why would anyone want it? But because of the trade agreement, bilateral trade agreement between Canada and Costa Rica, they're being sued for it. Hi, thank you, UK watching. I'll be finishing soon. I'm still waiting for the guys to come out. But in any case, okay, so what's happened now, the ISDS, Investor State Dispute Settlement, check it out, is being used by corporations to take governments to court. So that's it. $1 billion actually being used by Infinity Gold because they were prevented from opening a gold mine in Costa Rica. American, it's actually a petroleum company, sued Ecuador, and I believe they got nearly $2 billion against Ecuador. Ecuador was canceled the contract due to breach of contract, as far as I know, but then the petroleum company won. I can't remember the name of it at the moment. So that's what we face at the moment. Corporations will become more powerful than nation states. They won't even have to actually pretend that they are concerned about the environment or the community at all once the TTIP is signed. So please, if you want to, I've posted some articles in the occupylondon.org.uk website. I try to actually find the ones that are the easiest read. If you actually check out Occupy Law UK on Facebook, you'll actually see that we posted a number of articles about the TTIP as well. If you can, please keep sharing this. Rio Tinto is actually what we face at the moment. Put it this way, Rio Tinto got the Indonesian army to invade West Papua. That's the sort of future that we face. The Indonesian army became the mercenary army of Rio Tinto. It's obscene, but that is the future if the TTIP does go through. Then after that, check out the Alternative Trade Mandate. Again, that's Alternative Trade Mandate Alliance. I'm trying to push it to various groups, to Occupy as well. People need to read it. And it's a way for us, the 99%, to fight against the corporations. What we face with the TTIP, the TPP, the CEPA, is the worldwide corporate coup d'etat. So please, check them out. I shall be back once the guys are outside. I'm just here at the Queen Elizabeth II Conference Center were the ugly truths about Rio Tinto AGM. From what I gather, a number of tribal nations have actually gone there to ask questions. So hopefully, the more the better. So peace out. Thank you so much.